there. My name is Katie. I'm a student here at the University of Glasgow. I'm studying to get my master's in museum education. I'm originally from the States, but now I live in Winton Drive, one of the student accommodations. And I'm gonna take you around, show you what the complex is like, and show you a bit about my room and some of the common spaces. So we're gonna head up this way. The university offers a number of different student accommodations that are located around the city and around the university campus itself. So this is one of them. It is open for undergrad and postgrad students, but it seems as though more postgrad students tend to live here. I live in a flat, there's five of us, and we are all international students. So through here, you can see the laundry, so we'll head in here. There are washers and dryers for students to use. We have an app on our phone, and we just scan the QR codes on whichever machine we're using, and that's how we go about paying for and starting the washers and dryers. Yeah, it's really convenient because it's right under our flats. And then also right out here is where some of our bins are. So there's normal trash as well as recycling. And those bins are sort of throughout the complex, so it's easy to just pop your trash in on your way to class. We'll head into the building now and head up every flight of stairs in this building because I live on the top floor. We have keys to get in, so we have a little fob to scan our way into the building, and then keys to get ourselves into our flat and our rooms. Over here you can see there's also summer and winter heating times. So we do have heat, and it's nice because it's all handled for us. So it's one less thing for us to think about. Each floor has three flats here, and each flat has five students in it. So it's you and four flatmates, which is really nice. If you don't know anybody when you're coming here and you just want to sign up and meet all of your flatmates once you get here, that's totally fine. That's what I did. I didn't know anybody before I came. But if you're coming and you know other people who are coming and you want to live with them, you can also request to be flatmates with them. So I didn't know any of my flatmates when I got here, but two of my flatmates came to Glasgow together, and now they get to live together. This is my flat. And at the end of the hall is my room. So this is my space. When you get here, you have a mattress as well as sheets and your duvet and pillow. So that was really helpful, especially as an international student, I didn't have to bring an entire bed set over here. And I could get off the plane and immediately crash, which was nice. You have your chair, your desk, you get a lamp, plenty of storage space for all of your schoolwork, plenty of shelves for all your clothes and whatever else you have. And then you also get a closet space, so plenty of space in there, as well as a sink, mirror, light for that as well. So that's really helpful because, like I said, we're living with, there's five of us in these flats, so when it's time for everybody to go and brush their teeth before bed or anything, you get your own sink space, which is very helpful. So from here, we'll head into the kitchen. So the kitchen has plenty of space. It's got a freezer that we all share, as well as two fridges. So the fridges are shorter, but when you combine two little fridges together, it's about the size of one fridge, which is nice. We also get loads of cabinet space as well. So here's some of my stuff in my pantry, which is, there's loads of space. So all five of us share the kitchen, but like I said, we're never really competing for any space or anything. And then we have trash, glass recycling, and then paper and cardboard recycling as well. And as I pointed out earlier, the bins for that are all downstairs. So you have it in your flat and you just take it right downstairs and it's handled, which is really helpful. Also, part of the flats, you get a kettle, a toaster, a microwave. You have an iron, and there's an ironing board as well, but we keep that in the hallway. And then a whole bunch of cleaning supplies, so like mops and brooms, as well as the different like cleaning solutions as well. And then as you can see, there's also some like just general living spaces, places to sit and eat, places to just kind of hang out, which is all very nice. So this is our little kitchen space. And then from here in the hallway, we have our toilet area. There we go. So the toilet and the shower are in two separate rooms. So if somebody's taking a shower, you're still able to use the bathroom, which is nice. So that's our toilet area. And then this is our shower room. And then on our way out, right around the corner, you can see that there is a Hoover as well as that ironing board that I had mentioned. Those are both provided for us. So again, very helpful and very convenient to just have it there. And now we'll head downstairs and towards the common spaces, which are actually connected to another one of the student accommodations. Which is called Queen Margaret Drive. So Winton Drive is connected to Queen Margaret Drive, and I'll point that out as we head down. Get a lot of steps in on the stairs, but also this accommodation lets you get some steps in walking to the university. So it's about a 15 to 20 minute walk to the main campus, and you head through the botanical gardens to get there. So, hi. So it's a really lovely walk. Also, right outside of the Botanic Gardens is the pathway that gets you onto the Kelvin Walkway. So you can just hop on that, and it's a really lovely walk that takes you through the city, but it's all on a path next to the river, so it doesn't even feel like you're walking through the city. So I take a lot of walks on there. But yeah, it's about 15-20 minute walk to the university. It's about a 15 minute walk to the closest subway, which is on Byers Road. And then it's also about a 15-minute walk in the other direction towards the closest train station, which is really convenient because those trains can either take you through to other parts of Scotland, or it can take you in towards city center and to other stations as well. So you don't always have to take the subway, you can also take the train. Both of them are about equally far from the complex, but in opposite directions, so you kind of get to choose. Here are more flats for Winton Drive. Most of them look pretty similar. This is that. And then up ahead is sort of that connecting spot between Winton Drive and Queen Margaret. So once we walk down these stairs, we're in Queen Margaret Drive, which is typically a bit more for undergraduate students. But we do share the same reception space and common space, so we'll go and check that out now. There's also some like picnic places and places to hang out. It's a bit damp today, but normally on our rare but lovely sunny days, a lot of students will come and sit outside. And it's helpful because the Wi-Fi is all over, so you can come and do your schoolwork out here if you want. There's also more bin storage. This is typically used for Queen Margaret. The building we're going to check out, we share the sort of common spaces with the Queen Margaret students, but this is where their laundry is as well. Like I showed earlier though, the Winton Drive students, we all have laundry facilities inside of our buildings. So the facilities I showed are just for my building. Each of the separate buildings and blocks have their own laundry facilities for Winton Drive students. So while there is laundry in this building that we're about to head into, we don't really have to worry about that, because we can just pop downstairs and throw our laundry in at our building. We also have a security office right here. So that's really nice to know that the whole complex is always being watched over. The Winton Drive and Queen Margaret complexes are located in the West End, so it's a pretty quiet area where we are, but it's still nice that we have security here. Hello. So there's a reception space. There are some vending machines. There's a bathroom, and then in here is a common space. Hello. So this is just a common space for students to come and hang out. It's open for anybody in the area or in the complex. You can see study spaces as well as places to play different types of games. So different games set up here. Then if we head down this way, there are movies here, and right on the other side of this wall is a big TV, so they do hold movie nights. There is live-in student support here, so other students who are just here to help answer any questions or help with any issues you might have. Those students also hold different programs and events for all of us here to come to, so socials and stuff. I know for International Women's Day, they had like a pub quiz that had prizes of like all sorts of different snacks and different things like that. So there's always stuff going on down here. More spaces to hang out. Like I said, good places for a movie night. They also have different video game systems and stuff, so you can plug those in and play games here. If you're more into board games, those are also here. So in these cabinets, you could play, Connect Four. There's a bunch of different board games all in here as well. So video games, board games, up to you. And then the last thing to note is back in this corner, there are three computers set up for students. So if you need to use a computer for your homework or for schoolwork or anything, you're welcome to just pop down here. We do have computers in our library, but like I said, that's about a 15-minute walk. And if you wanted to just come down here to use a computer, you're more than welcome to. It's right down from our flats. So that's that. This is a bit about Winton Drive as well as our common spaces. Like I said, it's a flat that the university, it's part of university accommodations. 5 students in them. We share bathroom spaces and kitchen spaces. We get our own rooms. I hope you enjoyed seeing it.